Hello, this is Art, and I just want to talk to you about real estate real quick. It used to be fun to buy a house, and nowadays people have actual nightmares over it, and I get it, it's a battlefield of bidding wars out there, and it's not easy to win. But if you're well prepared and you have a solid strategy, you might be able to actually get it, all right? So I'm going to give you three quick tips that should help you make your purchase offer much stronger. Number one, and very obvious one. You need to be ready to spend more than you thought you were originally gonna spend, all right? And I'm not just saying just take all your money and throw it at the seller. You need to be very methodical over here, all right? What I mean by that, research the price point, because different selling agents, they take different strategies on how they're gonna sell the property. Some of them like to price it below market, so they get more interest, they get more offers coming in. Some of them like to price it right where it's at, or if someone is greedy, they're gonna price it much higher. It doesn't really matter where it's at because the market will dictate how much it's really gonna sell for, not the seller, but it gives you a good hint of what's the strategy there, how the seller is trying to get the money, and you'll be able to accommodate your offer to it. You'll be able to write your offer for that price strategy, okay? Because look, the seller is gonna get all these offers and they're gonna look through them and not necessarily pick the one that has the highest price, but they'll pick the one that has the most leverage in it. Because if the selling agent is a hardworking person, he's not lazy, he'll counter any offer that comes in, all right? And you need to make sure that you create a sense that there is leverage there, which what I mean is there is some good down payment. So there's room to go back and forth and actually give the seller some negotiating power, okay? Number two, that has to do something directly with that first part. You want to write an offer without loan contingency. Okay, that's very important. And your cushion is cash, all right? But cash is not always there, so it's pretty risky. So, what you can do is you need to make sure that you have a substantial down payment, you have a very solid credit, and you also talk to the underwriter or the mortgage broker to see what are the chances that the bank will remove appraisal contingency. Okay, so it's also good to have approval, or at least pre-approval for that particular property that you're writing an offer on. Get a reality check. What are your chances of the bank removing an appraisal contingency? Okay. Number three, which is much easier but very important, write an offer without inspection contingency. Okay. Last thing the seller is looking for is doing repairs on the house or giving you price cut because you discovered something about the property. Okay. They don't want to do that, especially in the seller's market, which makes all the sense. So, how you protect yourself from it? Get an inspection done before you write an offer. And maybe once the inspection is done, you will change your mind completely. Okay. So, those are three things that should help you write a much stronger offer and the offer that will stand out from the rest. One more a quick tip is a bonus for you. If you don't want to lose a bidding war, just don't participate in it. Okay. Just sit back and wait until this whole thing blows out. And it's gonna happen, okay? The feds are pouring water on the fire. They're trying to cool down the market, and the rates should be closer to 6% by the end of the year. And something has to give in, okay? You can't have very high interest rates, and you cannot have prices that are through the roof. The mortgage payments will be so high that there's gonna be a major drop off in buyers, okay? And you're just gonna have to wait, okay? Once that happens, you might be able to get into a home that you like and see that the price is gonna pull back a little bit. Not saying necessarily that will really reduce the prices of homes, but there'll be a little bit less competition. You'll be able to get in the house without going through so much stress, all right? So I hope this was helpful. There's a few tips for you. I hope they give you a couple of ideas, and I'll see you guys soon.